After the greatest minds behind the very first modern warfare turned their backs on the franchise and walked away, many wondered what their next venture would be. It's been many years since then, but Titanfall, developed by Respawn Entertainment, is essentially the answer we've been waiting for. Titanfall manages to mix two different styles of gameplay while making you, the player, feel like the most important person on the map. Getting around in Titanfall is easy. A jump pack allows you to perform all sorts of parkour moves, such as small or double jumps, wall runs, and even extended levels of travel over an entire battlefield. Titanfall is as much about verticality as it is about shooting, and it definitely nails the feeling perfectly. Having this type of mobility when Titans eventually populate the battlefield serves to even up the odds a bit. Once your timer reaches zero, you're able to summon one of your own hulking mechs to do whatever you want with. Let it follow you, guard an area, or hop in for direct control. Piloting a Titan feels like moving as a pilot on foot, although there's no fancy jumping involved. Instead, you're able to perform limited dashes in any direction, making sure Titan gameplay doesn't feel at all stagnant. The real trick comes in the way these two mechanics work together. Pilots are nimble and able to scurry around the battlefield through Titan's legs. They're a particularly hard target for Titans to shoot at, which makes them even more deadly when one decides to jump on your back and take shots at your squishy bits. That said, going up alone against one or more Titan is usually suicide unless you rend one yourself, and the constant shift of power between these two playstyles is fascinating to be a part of. It's amazing just how incredibly balanced it all is. Maps are cleverly designed to give pilots more of a vertical advantage while providing open areas for large Titan slugfests. Having each pilot equipped with an anti-Titan weapon helps even things out more, but it's the way you choose to equip your pilot weapon-wise that makes all the difference. Do you want to hunt AI grunts to shave off precious seconds from your Titan build time? Why not equip a smart pistol and avoid contact from other players? Want to take the fight directly to the enemy? Pick out an assault rifle that's good from long and short ranges, or opt for the close quarters shotgun. Use cloak and extended parkour abilities to get up close and personal in a short space of time. Titanfall wants to play to your strengths, even though the weapon roster is a little light. You can also use burn cards to spice each death up a little bit. Earn massive killstreaks during matches and you're rewarded with better burn cards, which are one-time boosts to either weapons, abilities, or Titan attributes for a single life. Once you use it, it's gone, so you have to be careful you don't waste all the really good ones before you can earn a few more. The only real problem here is pricing. Titanfall costs $60, the same as most full releases. While all the quality is here, it's hard to ignore games that achieve similar results, but also come with fully fleshed out single player experiences and cooperative modes. There's only 5 match types in Shoya, and bare bones options for frequent multiplayer fans such as private lobbies and clans. It just seems like Titanfall would be the perfect package if just a little bit cheaper. In the end, Titanfall delivers on what it promises. It really does feel like the next evolutionary step in online shooters, and while it may lack mainstream esports appeal for now, it's got what counts. Exhilarating gameplay, well-balanced mechanics, and just hours and hours of fun ahead. Titanfall delivers on the hype and deserves a spot on any shooter fan's shelf.